positivity is the base for a successful life. To implement it in practical is a real challenge though. Can you please tell us ways to keep our minds positive in unfavorable situations?
This is a very profound question. This is the crux of life. What you are asking is how to remain positive in the face of adversity. Now, we have to define what is adversity. Adverse circumstances are an inevitable part of the journey of life. You cannot come across a human being who had a linear growth all throughout his life. There are periods of ups and downs. There are vicissitudes. There are periods when you do a little and you get fantastic returns. You get into periods where you get output directly in proportion to the input in terms of labor and efforts, imagination and investment in terms of attention and all that. But there are also periods of diminishing returns where you go on making efforts day after day, week after week, month after month, but nothing meaningful comes out. So during those, or there could be sudden disaster in the family, or crisis at the workplace, or you could be served a what is called pink slip. You suddenly lose your job. All these things are possible. You lose your health, for example. These are all very, very trying times in the life of a human being. And actually, the real purpose of education is to prepare us for handling these situations. So one of the ways that I have followed in my life is that if the best of the times did not stay for too long, then the worst of the times shall also not stay for too long. So best of the times have come and gone. Likewise, the difficult time that you are encountering today shall also go or phase out. Secondly, we must know that there was a time when you were in the center of things, or when all were gazing at you for performance. How to remain alive, how to remain alert, how to remain active when you are put on the margins of life, when you are not at the center of things, when you are not in focus, but you are out of focus. At that time you will find, my dear students, that is the best time for understanding yourself. Success, whenever it comes to you, will take you out of you and away from you. Failure, whenever you are face to face with it, will cover you by darkness. Success brings brightness. Failure brings eclipse. How to remain peaceful during the eclipse? And there are positive aspects of the eclipse. Eclipse will introduce you to the deeper layers of your personality. Eclipse will connect you to the source from where you are drawing your primary energy. So if you start living in the moment, that means you don't think about the future. You don't think about the past. You think of now and here. You will find you will be able to come out of the night of your life or from the darkness of your life. Somebody asked me how to remain positive during the crisis period and during the period of eclipse. I gave him an example that if you are carrying a torch, keep it straight on the present, and you will cover a long journey of wild forest at night time. He said, but the journey is very long and the woods are very wild and there are wild animals around and beasts and reptiles and serpents and snakes and so on. I simply told him that you start your journey. You start your journey by keeping the torch straight. When you keep the torch straight and take two steps further, the light has also moved two steps further. So every time you take a step, the light keeps on moving and you cover the entire journey of darkness. But when the sun will rise and you go look back at how the night has passed, you will become a very, very strong person. A person who has who is rooted in the self, a person who can achieve success despite all difficult circumstances, difficult trials of life and tribulations of environment. So the best way of handling the crisis and remaining positive during the crisis is to connect yourself to the basic source of your energy and live in the present. The moment you start thinking of the distant future or the hoary past, you will lose confidence. So make the best possible use of the available resources at that time and keep this torch. This torch is not outside you. It is not a torch driven by battery. It is a torch driven by the third eye of imagination, third eye of knowledge. This torch is that torch, that ignition, that light, which can see during the dark period, which can see everything clearly during deep darkness. So connect yourself to that and life will become a wonderful experience. Thank you.